It's Fabricland time.
I need zippers.
That's a bit too many for one skirt, no?
There's three for a dollar.
Oh.
We gotta stock up on zippers. I don't want another zipper fiasco.
I suppose that's acceptable. Yeah. And now we're looking at skizzers.
I dropped one on my foot.
Way to go.
I think it was... Oh, no! I cut myself. Good.
Oh. Did you drop like an open pair of scissors?
I thought it landed like that. But maybe
well, apparently
it landed
like with
that.
The tip down. Good job. Is that a nativity fabric?
I want to make a little quilt out of it.
Good.
Just have baby Jesus all over my bed.
Awesome. We also found printed swimwear. We can make our own bathing suits. We could be so stylish making our own.
Pretty ambitious.
Yeah, probably about. It's very stretchy. Stretchy things are hard to work with.
Yeah.
So. I'm gonna skip that.
Just it'll probably fall apart if you get into the water, which is not something.
No, you don't want that to happen. Probably not. No. What you got there though?
I found some on sale fabrics.
Nice.
So this is a cool thingy.
Dalmatians.
And then that's the cool thing.
Cool thingies.
I like it.
I found some Canada fabric. Oh, Canada, our home and native land.
Yes.
Too bad it doesn't say it's Canada outside. Because if it said it's Canada outside, I would have to buy it.
Yeah.
So we found the food themed section. And now I want food.
I'm starving. Look at these cupcakes.
There's like cupcakes, which are, they look actually delicious.
Mm-hmm.
And then over here, there's like a whole aisle of just food. Any fruit and vegetable that you want, you can find it here in fabric version. Not very edible,
no.
But they look delicious. We should put the ants all over the food. And it would be funny.
You should make a like picnic blanket out of it.
Yes. Although white is not so good.
There's
a blue one. You know, when you put it down on the ground, it doesn't go all not white right away.
Exactly.
So that's a good idea.
It's like a clever little trick.
Hello vlog. Remember a while ago we went to Toronto and met up with Tim Deegan and went to the Tiff Bell Lightbox building and filmed a video? Well, I've been working on said video. It's basically a promotion video for the Buffer Festival and explains exactly what's supposed to happen and when it happens and what's going on. And it's beautiful Tim Deegan talking. And I just finished the main edit of the video.
So here it is. That is our timeline. Now you can see all of this is Tim Deegan talking, and then all of that top layer there is all B-roll stuff.
Now the thing about videos like this is that it's a lot of information, so just having Tim Deegan talking about stuff would get pretty boring because it's just fact after fact. So we put a lot of B-roll on top of it, and we filmed a bunch of B-roll at the TIFF building when we were there, but most of that is just empty halls and empty chairs, and we wanted to include some actual people in seats. And the convenient thing is that we film our daily lives, as you may know. And last September we went to an event at the TIFF Bell Lightbox. It was called Nuit Blanche, which is like an all-night art festival, and Gunnarola and Andrew Bravener had this thing that they were doing, like an all-night showing YouTube videos thing. So we went to that and we vlogged. I got a bunch of footage from that. We also had a pre-buffer demo night where people could buy tickets, and we had like a small little event of what buffer would basically be. A bunch of stuff has changed since then, but I also managed to use some footage from that from our vlog. So we got a fun little video. Now this video is gonna go live at the same time as the website. Corrado's gonna do a couple little graphic-y things and do color corrections so everything matches, and then hopefully you'll be able to see it soon, so look out for that.
Welcome to our bookshelf tour. apparently some of you have been asking about all of the things we have on here. Most of these things belong to Corey.
Yes.
So we're just gonna assume that we know everything about Corey and talk about all of his things.
Mm-hmm.
Corey's glasses.
Corey's glasses. We got Corey's books over here, including all of the John Green books,
yeah,
which are very important to have. And then, you know, Scott Pilgrim, because Canada.
Mm-hmm.
We got some movies right here.
Oh, lots of movies.
We got lots of movies. I think these are games.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Those are places.
Okay, so this is games.
This is the game shelf.
And this is the movies. And this is like seasons things.
Yeah.
And, you know, Star Wars.
Yeah.
These things belong to like 8 different people.
Mm-hmm.
We just kind of like have 800 systems and just collected
we
them and gathered them and put them on the shelf
together.
So this section does not actually belong to Corey.
Well, these are all
specifically
quarries.
Right. Okay. So is this quarries?
No. Some of these are quarries.
Okay. Well, this is a jumble of people's things.
Lots of games.
Boys. I don't think there's any. I think all of these are boy games.
I might have one Wii game.
Okay. Sam has one Wii game.
Actually, I don't even think it's there.
No.
I own one. I don't know where it is.
Okay. Cool. And then you know we've got our Star Wars things, and our Google things, and our Indiana Jones things, because all of these things are super important. And
this is a R2-D2 cassette player.
Yes,
it's a cassette player. I didn't even know that.
You didn't know that?
No.
I don't know how to use it. Corey told me it's a cassette player and it has buttons. Oh, look at that!
There
right
you go.
There.
There's a cassette part.
There you go.
That's really cool.
There it is. Stop forward
play. I didn't know
play.
That.
Yep. And power in.
That's very cool.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah. This is cooler though.
Way cooler.
I think most of you know this already because we've showed this to the vlog before. I don't know when, but it's the Harry Potter box set of all of the Harry Potter things, and it takes up all of the space. So that's important. And that's our bookshelf.
Yay!
It's got things on it that belong to everybody, but mostly Corey.
Mostly Corey.
So yeah. Hope you enjoyed our tour.
Well, hey guys. So now that I have my zipper, I decided to sew it onto my skirt. And here's the thing. Zippers are really annoying and they're very difficult. And I've had nothing but trouble with this one literally all night. What makes matters worse is that like my sewing isn't exact. So to sew something very precisely onto something that's not very precise is pretty difficult.
Another thing is that when I picked out the zipper, I was like, oh, it's gray. It's light gray, it'll go with the skirt. Now that I have it on, it looks more like a baby blue, which is kind of confusing. But I mean, you won't really see it, so it should be okay. Also, I made the mistake of sewing the part that doesn't have the zipper all the way up to the top, so now there's just this hole. I messed up so many times. Like, I went, like, way too close to the zipper, and then the zipper wouldn't unzip, and then I went, like, inside of the zipper I sewed, and just, it went all around. It is not pretty, to say the least. It's just so bad. Like, it goes in there and out there, and it's uneven, and it's ugly, but at least it's on. So, now I have to rip the stitches all along here and open it up and see if it actually works. Yay, so I'm done ripping the stitches. Got all the way down to the bottom. You can see I did a very bad job of sewing it in the first place because this is so lopsided. This side, the flap is really big, and this side, the flap is really tiny. So, you know, at least I tried.
Guys, it's done.
Pulled all the stitches, I tried it on, I hemmed it, and now it's done.
I'm gonna try it on for you guys because I can.
Don't mind the messy room, but here it is. Yay, and apparently it's not actually done because this part sticks out weird and I don't really know. We'll have to fix that. But here it is. It's really high-waisted. but I think it turned out pretty good for a first time thing, you know. Yeah.
Daily vlogs, I want them in my subscription box. I wonder who might drop by, even though sometimes it's Canada outside. So don't go away, we're here every day. It's not Apprentice A, it's Apprentice A.
Hey, 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 hey.
Home is where the vlog is.